Hey, how's it going, everybody? It's your bro here. Hope you're doing well. And in this video, I'm going to be teaching you guys all about basic animations in CSS. So let's get into it. Before you reach the end of this video, make sure to like, comment, and subscribe so that we together can challenge and defeat the mighty YouTube algorithm. Hey everyone, so basically speaking, an animation allows us to change some property of an element over the course of time instead of having it become an instantaneous change, which is what we're used to. So let's begin by creating some sample text to work with. So on my HTML document, I'm just going to use a paragraph tag. I'll give this a unique ID of P1, and then I'll just type in the word maybe hi again, like what we did with the last video. So then we'll close this, save the page, reload, and then let's go to our style sheet and let's work on a square for our paragraph element. Well, let's target P1 since we're already using an ID. All right, so let's make a square. So we'll give this a width of 100 pixels and a height of 100 pixels. And then background, maybe red. All right, then font size. I think last time we picked 85. Text align center and margin 0 pixels. Let's save, reload the page. Okay, this will work for now. Moving on to our next step. What we need to do now is to create something called a keyframe rule. And this is basically the animation itself. Any element that is using this keyframe rule will behave based on the animation steps that are listed within this rule. So what we'll do for a keyframe rule is type in at keyframes, and then we need a unique name for this animation. Let's say that we want to change the color from red to blue. We could call this maybe my color animation. Otherwise, name this whatever you want. You could still name this like best animation ever. And this would still work, but you know, your name should be descriptive of what the animation does. So I'll just call this my color animation, then a set of curly braces. All right, this is the framework for the keyframe rule. We'll need some sort of starting position and ending position. The first line, we're going to type from, then a set of curly braces. And the second line, to, another set of curly braces. We can list some sort of property within this from line, and this will be like the starting position. So we can say background dash color should start at red. And then at the end on this to line, we'll type in background dash color, maybe blue. All right. Now within an element that you want to use this animation, what we're going to do is use the animation property. So animation colon, and then we're going to take our animation name that we want to use and place it right here next to the property name for animation. Now second, we'll need a duration. How long do we want this animation to take? So we'll use this property called animation duration. And let's say that we want this animation to take 5 seconds. So we'll place 5s here. So let's save. And after reloading the page, now the background color of our element changed from red to blue, but it only does this once, so you can actually set something called an animation iteration count. So let's say if you want to have this animation occur twice, you could put 2 here. Otherwise, if you want this to be continuous, you can place the word infinite. So then after using animation iteration count infinite, this animation will continuously occur infinitely then. So we can also list multiple different steps in our animation. It doesn't necessarily have to be 2, but what we're going to do here is list some percentages instead of this keyword from and to. So we could actually have this transition to a bunch of different colors. So I think that's what we'll do then. So maybe 6 different colors. So maybe red, orange, yellow, green, blue, and maybe lastly, purple. That should be good enough. Okay, so next to each of these basically steps, we're going to list a percentage. So we're going to start at 0%. And for the second step, we'll say that when our animation reaches 20%, we want the color to be orange. And we could list 40% for the next step, then 60, 80, and then when this animation finishes, the color should be purple. So now this square should transition to a bunch of different colors. And we also set an iteration count of infinite, so it's just going to continue on and on. So you can also use percentages for your animation. It doesn't necessarily just have to be from and to. Let's rotate this bad boy. Let's create a new animation. So at keyframes, my rotate animation, because I can't think of a more clever name at the moment. So what we'll just do here is say maybe 100%. What do we want this animation to do? Well, we're going to use the transform property and let's rotate this on its Z axis, but make sure this first letter is lowercase. And then we're going to put an amount of degrees. So let's say we want this to rotate 360 degrees. Then I just need a semicolon and then we should be good. And we're going to change the animation from my color animation to my rotate animation. So what this does now is that it rotates on its Z axis 360 degrees over the course of 5 seconds. And we also set this to infinite, so it's just going to continue on and on. You know, you could also increase this or decrease this. So 720 degrees would have this rotate a little bit faster. Let's just set this to like a million or something and it should go crazy. Yeah, sorry if I gave you a seizure. All right, so maybe we'll just set that to 360 degrees for now. And let's rotate this on multiple different axes. Is that plural for axis? I don't know. You know what I mean though. All right, so X, Y, and Z, but I'm going to turn a few of these into a comment. All right, so maybe we'll just start with X. And this should be a comment too. Okay, so now it's rotating on its X axis. And let's also rotate this on the Y axis. That's a pretty sweet animation. All right, so that's how you use a rotation sort of animation. Let's try another type of animation. Okay, I have an idea. Let's move our element around the screen using the translate property. So let's create a new animation for this. So keyframes, my, I don't know, translate. All right, then what I think we'll do actually is set this to 50% and you'll see why in just a moment. All right, then what we'll do here is use transform, translate. So this takes two values, an X position and a Y position. So if we want to move this maybe 100 pixels to the right, we'll just place 100 pixels here followed by zero. And then let's list this animation here. So I'm just going to copy this and paste it, save, reload. And now this moves all the way to the right. But now since we set this to 50%, when it reaches 100, it's actually going to go back to its original position. Now, if this was 100%, what ends up happening is that when it reaches the end, it's kind of going to like blink back to where it was previously. So if you want this to look more natural and kind of ease its way back in, you could set this to 50%. And then when it starts to reach 100 or after 50%, it's going to go back to its original position. So that's something to consider too, if you want something to ease back into where it was originally. Let's also move this downwards, so on the Y axis. So I'll set that to 100 pixels and I'll set the first value to zero. So now this is moving down and you can actually combine the two. So let's move this 100 by 100 pixels and you get like a diagonal animation, which is pretty sweet. All right, let's go over scaling animations. So let's create a new keyframe, keyframes my scale. And maybe I'll set this to 50%. Then we're going to use transform scale 2x2. And then we'll list this new animation here. Okay, now the size of our element is scaling up by 2. Or if we put maybe 3 here, you know, it's scaling on its x-axis 3 times the original size and the y-axis 2 times. Otherwise, you can always shrink this too. We could say 0.5 and 0.5. And then it's getting smaller and it's pulling back up to its normal size as well. Let's change the opacity. I promise we're almost done. We just have a few other things to cover. So my opacity, and let's have this start at 0% with the opacity. Opacity is like basically the visibility. So we'll set this to 0, and at 50%, we want the opacity to be 1, which is basically 100%. And then at 100%, we want the opacity here to be 0 again. And then let's list this as the animation now. So what ends up happening is that it fades in and then it fades out, which is pretty sweet too. And lastly, let's change the font size over time. So you can basically pick like any property that you want to change. I'm just making stuff up as I go along here, but you know, there's more you can do with these. You can also combine different transformations and animations too. I'm just taking this like step by step. So maybe let's call this animation my font. And then at 0% of this animation, we'll have the font dash size be 85 pixels, which is what we set it to originally. 50% font dash size, maybe 400. So the size of our font is going to expand to fill our window. And then at 100%, we want this, the font size, to go back to 85. And let's list this as the new animation, paste it here, and let's try this. All right, it's aggressively saying hi to us. All right, guys, well, there's one thing I forgot to mention to you. So you can actually have an animation begin when you hover over an element. So for example, let's say that we want this animation to occur only when we move our mouse cursor over this red box, our element. So what we'll do is we'll take our element, and for our example, it's P1, and we're going to use the hover pseudo class. Take all of the animation properties listed for this element and place it within the pseudo class. So we'll just place that here. All right, so let's save this, reload the page. And when this page is reloaded, it doesn't appear to do anything until you move your mouse cursor over it, then the animation begins. So I thought I would just throw that in real quick before we wrapped up this video. So that's the very basics of animations in CSS. If you would like a copy of everything we worked on today, I'll post this in the comments down below. But yeah, that's the basics of animations in CSS. Hey you. Yeah, I'm talking to you. If you learn something new, then you can help me help you in 3 easy steps by smashing that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.